Hello. My name is Shelly, and that's about it. So, as the title of this video suggests, this is a book haul. Yes. Because, you know, we cannot go in life without book hauls. So, very, very recently, I went and visited my friend Holly, and she gave me a bunch of books. I'm very, very excited about this because, you know, I love books. Who doesn't? And if you're on this channel and don't love books, I have no words. I'm joking. You might just like seeing me being mean to myself, or, you know, being stupid, because that's basically, that's feels like me in a nutshell. So, like I mentioned, most of the books are from Holly, and some are books that I've gotten myself for various reasons. Most of the books I've gotten myself are either for our book club picks or read-alongs. So, you know, I have a bunch of books. Most of them I don't know anything about. Basically, I don't think I know anything about any of the books, but, you know, that's me in a nutshell. My book hauls are usually, here's a pretty book cover. Let's see if we can read it. So I have two big piles of books, and yeah, I'm a bit scared now. Not gonna lie. Okay, let's start with the hardback books because they're big and they can go in the bottom of my big piles. Okay. The first book we have is The Christmas Bookshop by Jenny Colgan. It's my first Jenny Colgan hardback, so I... Yeah, I do like doing that. I'm pretty sure this is part of the, what's it called? Scottish? The Scottish Bookshop series. I don't know if that's the official title of the series, but that's what we're calling them for now. So, I mean, a book about books. We do like that. I just want to do this. Yeah, it's a very nice sounding hardback book. So yeah, it's a Christmas book. So I might not read it until Christmas. I might like collect a bunch of Christmas books this year and then do like a big Christmas read. That's a thought. That is a thought. So, you know, moving on, we have The Prison Healer by Lynette Nonne. This is a book we have seen a lot of on Bookstagram, isn't it? I mean, probably BookTube as well. I don't know what it's about. A prison healer? A healer in a prison? But it seems like a decent-sized book, so, you know... It is on my list of books that I want to read. I don't know what it's about. Don't Let Her Die, We Are Coming. Oh, okay. Another book. I hadn't, like, seen this book around until very, very recently. Holly did mention it, before Christmas, I think. But... I have no idea. I have no idea. So it's Midnight in Everwood by M.A. Cusinar. It's a pretty cover. And I mean, look at those sprayed edges. Yeah, I'm a sucker for pretty covers and sprayed edges. I shouldn't lie. I shouldn't lie. I do not tell lies. Is this the one that's like a nutcracker retelling? Ballerina? Something? I wonder if this is the like nutcracker retelling. Could be. You know, feel free to like say differently. I don't know. I don't make research, okay? I don't read blurbs. I just like looking at pretty books and going like, ah, that's probably a good read, let's read it. That's usually how I go. So this is called Dear Reader, The Comfort and Joy of Books by Kathy Rensenbrink. I'm pretty sure this is a non-fiction book. What makes me think that? I don't know. It's very blue. Oh yeah, I'm pretty sure this is a non-fiction book, but I mean, look at the details in this, on this cover. I'm not even sure what it is. Flowers from a book. Yeah, so I'm pretty sure it's a non-fiction, like I've said like 500 times now, but next up we have The Cat Who Saved Books by Suzuki Natsukawa. The thing yeah, don't come at me, I don't know names and words. Let's see, can I? No, it's very shiny. Okay, so there's a cat, and there's books on the cover. That's basically all I need, cats and books. Because, you know, I have a million of them. Grandpa used to say all the time, books have tremendous power, but what is that power really? I don't know. What is this book about? The Cat Who Saved Books is a heartwarming story about finding courage, caring for others, and the tremendous power of books. I mean, what more do you need? What more do you need? Moving on. So next up we have Boy Queen by George Lester. And I'm pretty sure this is semi-based on the author's own experiences. Is it like his upbringing or just his experiences in life? I don't know. But am I saying it right? Yeah, something, there's drag in it. And you know, I'm here for it. I love that. Also, this cover makes me think of something, but I'm not sure what. I don't know. Oh. Robin has it all figured out. A future on Broadway, a top secret boyfriend. Ooh. Top secret boyfriend. Two ride or die best friends, and then all his worst nightmares came true. Now his life is a hot mess. Hot mess life. Yes, here for that. So, a very popular series, or, you know, a series that is mentioned a lot, or the author is mentioned a lot anyway. It is, is it called the same thing? It's Nevernight by Jay Kristoff. I'm pretty sure the series is called Nevernight as well, or something like that. I don't know what it's about. But I mean, it's Nevernight, it's Jay Kristoff, who goes up and down as a problematic author. I have no words about that, but yeah, it is a book I've been wanting to read as well, because I'm kind of curious about, because I read the Illuminae book, the first one, not the rest yet, but that is written with Amy Kaufman, so I mean I don't know if what part is Amy Kaufman and what part is Jay Kristoff, so I have no sense of his own writing, as it were. Oh dear, this font is tiny. Lovely! But I mean, first book in that series, might get to this year sometime somewhere. I don't know. A book I have absolutely no knowledge about, because I'm not sure I've seen it or not. Well, Yeah, I did the other day, but that doesn't say much anyway. So it is called Guard Your Heart by Sue Divin. I want to say it's like a contemporary book, and it probably is. What if peace is harder than war? What if love is hardest of all? Okay. But it is a short one, so I mean, I'm here for a short book because have you seen my February TBR? Do I have this on my 22 books to read in 2022 list? That's a lot bigger than 22 books, but oh, I don't remember. Anyway, it is Kate in Waiting by Becky Albertalli. That's probably right. Another contemporary, I do believe. She's the one that wrote Simon and the Simon and the Homo Sapiens, I think. Sapiens Agenda. Ooh, there's a. Oh, I found a sticker. Holly, did you not finish this book? I don't know. Break. Yeah. Oh, it says right here, Love, Simon. So yeah, it is the. Hang on, Love, Simon is the movie based off of the book called Simon and the Homo Sapiens Agenda. Is that right? Something like that, something like that. Another contemporary book. Yes. Another Christmas book. So we have A Christmas. No, A Surprise Christmas Wedding by Philippa Ashley. Excuse me. No, I don't. I think it's one of those rom-com books, isn't it? Rom-com, Christmassy books. I'm not actually reading what's the text. I'm just looking at it and I see Christmas something. A lot of Christmas words. I do like these kinds of books. I don't read them often enough anymore, but I do really like these. Not just Christmas books, but you know, rom-com chick lit books. That's the word I was looking for. Since it is a Christmas book, and I don't know if it's in a series or not, I shall look at that up before I actually read it. But if it's not, you know, Christmas book, Christmas book, Christmas vloggy book reading. Who knows? Who knows? We have another non-fiction book. Jeez, where's the words today? It's How to Be a Woman by Caitlin Moran. I don't know much about Caitlin Moran, but this book is one that has been going around for quite some time now. I don't remember when it first came out, but a while back. And I do believe there's like sequel-ish kind of book follow-up. What do you call it when it's a non-fiction book? Oh, whatever. I don't remember what I was gonna say about this book. If I remember correctly, it's like a lot feminist kind of a book, non-fiction book. Something like that. I have heard that this book is very good. So, I mean, I don't read enough non-fiction. I haven't read non-fiction in a very long time. So, I mean, short book is the, yeah, the font is normal size. So, yeah, I mean, this is gonna be hopefully a very good read. We shall see. Oh, we shall see. Got loads more books. That was just about half the books. So, you know, if you want to take a break, pause the video, go get yourself another snack or something to drink, you know. So these next two books you've probably already seen in my February TBR video because I'm pretty sure this one is coming up after that one. But you know, I'm gonna mention them anyway because they are new books. Semi-new books, new books to me. Okay, so we have To Sleep in a Sea of Stars by Christopher Paolini, which is our February, I almost said TBR, February book club pick of the month. It's a chunky one and I'm not looking forward to it, but gotta support them friends. Another chunky book that's it's not part of the book club, but my good friend Val is having a read-along of it. And it is The Priory of the Orange Tree by Samantha Shannon. Chunky book, chunky book. I'm gonna need some like very, very thin books soon because I'm dying. I'm drowning in chunky books. Yeah, I'm just being melodramatic here. Another book club pick of the month that is for March. Do I know the names of the months? No, I don't. This is a book that I've been wanting to read for a very long time. It's not as chunky as the other ones, so you know. It is A Good Omens by Terry Pratchett and Neil Gaiman. And what something I very recently discovered when I was putting the piles of books in front of me is that I'm pretty sure there's like two covers. I mean, there's more than one cover for this book, but for this one in particular, I think there's like an angel version of this cover. So this is the, you know, the devil version, or you know, whatever it's called. Not too happy about this non-sticker movie sticker thing. Well, TV series basically. But it is Michael Sheen and David Tennant, two actors I do really appreciate. So I'm gonna let that slide for now. But you know, publishers, why don't you do this to us? So yes, I have seen the Amazon Prime original series. Is it a BBC one too? BBC series, no, a Prime original. Okay. I don't know, too many words. I have seen the series and so good, so good. These actors are just perfect for that show. I'm just saying. So I'm very excited to read this book, so I can, you know, rewatch the series because I really want to rewatch the series. It's not a very long book, so hopefully that will go fast. Something I've heard though is that they're doing a second series of the show, which I'm not too sure how that's gonna go because I mean, I did see the series and it has a very good ending, so I'm like, how do you continue on with that? And also, I've not read the book, but from people who have read the book, they have said that the series, the TV series, and the book follow along very nicely, and it's basically this, the TV series and the book's ending is, you know, the end. So how? But you know, yeah, no. So, some more book club picks that we haven't actually announced yet, so I'm not gonna say for which month they are, but I have three more book club picks, I believe. So I'm just gonna mention them, and you know, as usual, I know nothing about these books, but they're books, so we're gonna mention the books. We're just not gonna mention a lot about what they're about because have we actually done that for this entire video? No, not really. So, another book club pick. I don't know which month it is, so that's why I'm not mentioning which month it is. I don't have that list in my head, you know? No. I'm joking. So, we have Warbreaker by Brandon Sanderson. So, you know, that's coming up sometime after March, because that's all I know. I know up to the March books, okay. Another Brandon Sanderson book we are reading this year for our book club is Skyward. So, you know, there's that one. It's in one of the months of this year. You know, and this one is actually sometime in the fall, and it's actually another pick of mine. It is The Starless Sea by Erin Morgenstern. I don't know which month it is, okay. It's sometime after summer, I'm pretty sure. But it is one I've been wanting to read for a while, as well as The Night Circus, which I don't have, but hopefully I will get it sometime soon and read that one as well. I don't know. I just like the cover, okay? I don't know what it's about. So, not many books left now. Not many books left. We have The Midnight... The Midnight Library by Matt Haig. And it's a tiny book. I'm here for a tiny book. It's something about you go through this library of choices of different lives that you could have lived. That's basically what I know about it. And that's not saying a lot, is it? That's nothing. And we have another Christmas book. It is from a series that I've read all the books so far. Yeah, so this is the last book in this series currently. You know, you never know if they do more books. So it's Christmas Shopaholic by Sophie Kinsella. Maybe one for the Christmas list? We shall see. I feel like I'm gonna have to start making like a list of Christmas books now that I can just look forward to in December or something. Yeah, maybe that's what I'm doing after I'm finished with this video. Okay. So, for the very, very last book of this haul, because there's been a lot. There's been a lot of books in this haul. So, for the very last book, we have Ariadne by Jennifer Saint. So, this is a Greek mythology retelling of some sort. I do not know more than that, but it is a pretty cover, so... You know, this, that. Well, those were a lot of books, and I have no idea where to start with them, you know, except for the ones that have, like, specific months in the book club. I don't know. Really don't know. I mean, I don't even know what most of them are about, or in some little inkling of, you know, kind of what category to put them in. So, I mean, we'll see. It'll probably be a good thing. Maybe not. We'll see how it all goes, but there were a lot of Christmas books, weren't there? I mean, not a lot, but a few. More than normal. So, I mean, let me know if you think it would be a good idea to, like, collect all the Christmas books or as many Christmas books as I can and, you know, do reading vlogs in December for Bookmas, most likely. I mean, I could like for Bookmas, I could like do a Christmas book reading vlog every week. I mean, there are quite a few other videos. So maybe dividing up a reading vlog in there would be a good idea. I don't know. I don't know. Let me know what you think. And, thank you so much for watching. Any of the books that speak to you, which one should I start with? Where should I go? Where should I go with all the books? Let me know. And, thanks for watching. And I'll see you all next time. I'll take care. Bye-bye.